So there was a question on why, when we go from 1D problems to multiple dimensional or 3D problems, we don't directly go up to elasticity, whereas we really set up the 1D problem mainly in the context of elasticity, right? Because even though we said it applies to other problems, heat conduction and diffusion as well in 1D, we did repeatedly make use of the physical analogy, of the physical underlying phenomenon being elasticity, right? The reason we don't directly go to three-dimensional elasticity is because for 3D elasticity to be posed, our unknown is the displacement, which is a vector, right? And handling vector unknowns is more complicated from the standpoint of the PDE itself. Our PDEs turn out to actually be three PDEs for each of the vector components. The constitutive relations get a little more complicated, and actually the boundary conditions need some careful bookkeeping. And as you may imagine, the same thing translates over, carries over into our finite element implementation. So we will get to 3D elasticity, of course. We will look at vector problems in 3D, but it's probably going to be a little easier having first gone through the scalar problem in 3D. Okay, so to be followed.